putty on these windows. There are two kinds of putty. One is proper linseed oil putty, and the other one is a kind of modern plastic type. I don't know what that's made out of. But the way that I bring these back, this old cracked putty, is just to take a mixture of linseed oil putty and the actual paint that I'm painting with, and I just use my fingers and draw it across the surface like that. These are just small gaps. You can use a putty knife as well. The idea is that you make a kind of liquid putty and it fills up the gaps, and then when you paint it, it seals up for the ingress of water, preventing the ingress of water, which should make the old putty have a new lease of life. If the old putty is nice and hard but just cracked, it still works okay. Obviously, you take out any bits that are loose. This paint I just made fresh this morning, it's just linseed oil and pigment, titanium white and zinc white. It's about 30% zinc, 70% titanium. It's quite thin, I've got quite a lot of oil in it, so I'm going to let this dry horizontally, otherwise it would just drip. Now these parts have been redone with this plastic putty, which means that the middle glass there is probably from 1996. I've washed all of the woodwork with what's called, is it salmiak in English? As a kind of degreaser. But I've also rubbed over the whole surface with 80 grit sandpaper. When I paint these edges, I allow the paint to go down onto the glass. That's to help prevent the ingress of water. The consistency of the paint that I've made is like a kind of thick cream or not very thick cream, but it's stickier than cream, so it's probably not a very good example. And I haven't ground the pigment, I've just mixed it together, just stirred it in. You see that the pigment mixes in nicely enough just with the brush. You can see those little drips there, which just show how drippy this paint is, really. It's very, very, very thin. You can add other things to the paint to make it easy to use, like chalk and Harpix. But this is very simple, I think. Perhaps in simple is best. I took with me a jam jar with this painting. It's about 2 deciliters I've brought with me, but it seems like I'm not going to use very much of that at all. In fact, I think I'm probably not going to use more than about 2 teaspoons full of paint, maybe 3. This window, and I've already done one window. On a painted surface, I think that if I remember right, in the past I've managed to get 35 square meters of coverage from a liter of this paint. So another little thing to remember with linseed oil paint is that you shouldn't really paint up on top of it with anything else other than linseed oil paint. This window has been painted, I think probably at the factory when it was built, spray painted, and it's lasted since 1996, and that's not too bad, but it was in actually pretty bad state at the bottom of the window where it gets wet. The paint just comes off in strips. Typical damage for alkyd oil paint once it gets a bit dry. And there was quite a lot of fungus growth in the putty. On the putty, both the old putty and the new. So the zinc in the paint is what's supposed to be getting, stopping that from developing, but in truth linseed oil paint is quite susceptible for a kind of black fungus that grows on it, which doesn't actually damage it because it's just air nourished, but it's not very sightly. You can actually get rid of that with chlorine. If you have a 3% water with 3% chlorine in it, that washes off the black fungus. But I mean, I don't know. This is maybe specific to Norway. I'm not sure. Well, I can't speak for other countries, what happens. But although it's unsightly, it doesn't do any damage. And really, although I understand that the aesthetics are very important with the way things, you know, look like they've been well looked after, it's a lot very important for a lot of people. But personally, I think that the technical aspects are paramount. And 1 or 2 coats of linseed oil paint on a window should be the absolute maximum, because windows are very susceptible for having condensation in them and developing the water inside the woodwork. And if you have a thick layer of paint on windows, really, it doesn't do you any good because it just holds that moisture in. It's one of the reasons why the paint cracks and deteriorates quite quickly on windows, is because the woodwork in them is humid, and that's really to do with condensation more than from rain. So you want to have as diffusion open solution as possible to counteract that.